Hello everyone, my name is Sam Spade and welcome to another Coding Fundamentals in GML tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about functions. A function is a sequence of programming instructions that performs a specific task and it's packaged as a unit. In other words, it's a complex action that you can tell the computer to take with a single command. So put this even more simply, it does something. Functions may take one or more inputs called arguments, and they may provide one and only one output. And they also may not take any inputs, and they may not provide any output. A basic diagram of a function looks a little bit like this. You have the input, which is optional. Then the function would do something. If there was input, it would use that input to do something. But if it didn't require input, it might just act on something. And perhaps the function would produce output. It would give you something in return. GameMaker Studio 2 has a lot of built-in functions. One thing I want to stress is that you must use the manual to find out how a function works, how a built-in function in GameMaker Studio 2 works. The manual will tell you what it does, what inputs or arguments the function takes, and what it returns, if anything. And using the manual is the only way to know this, because functions in GameMaker Studio 2, the built-in functions in GameMaker Studio 2, are specific to GameMaker Studio 2. There are also ways to create your own functions, and in GameMaker Studio 2, these are called scripts. At the moment, there is effectively no difference between the built-in functions in GameMaker Studio 2 and the scripts that you write. However, that's going to be changing in an update soon. We're going to have one or more, perhaps, tutorials on scripts, so the rest of this tutorial will be focused on the idea of functions in general, and specifically the built-in functions, or the idea of built-in functions that come with GameMaker Studio 2. The basic form of a function looks like this. You have the function name, and then you have each input or each argument separated by a comma. One thing worth noting is that a function may not take the same amount of arguments each time. It might have optional arguments. The way the GameMaker Studio 2 manual notes that is with brackets. So these arguments are optional. So this is a real function in GameMaker Studio 2. It takes the list ID, and then it takes the values, or the things that you want to add to the list, and it requires at least one, but it can have many more. So if you saw something like this in the manual, you would know that these two arguments are mandatory, but you can also have more arguments, and these arguments are optional. So to revisit our earlier diagram, a function does something, and it can have optional input and optional output, where the input is an argument or multiple arguments, and the output is a single return value. Here are some examples of built-in GameMaker functions. Window center doesn't require any inputs. It simply acts on the game window to center it on the monitor. Window set position takes two inputs, but doesn't provide any output. It takes an X and a Y position, and it will put your window in that position on your monitor. Random takes both an input and provides an output. And I want to go through the manual's page for each one of these as well, so you get an idea of how to look something up in the manual and read and understand what it is telling you. So here's the page for window center. First, it tells you what it does, is that it will center the game window in the display on the following platforms, or in the browser if you have the HTML5 platform. It also tells you that it will have no effect on any other device. It gives you the syntax, and then it tells you what it returns, and then it gives you a helpful example. The manual page for window set position is similar, except as this one takes arguments, it tells you about the arguments down here, the X coordinate of where to position the window, the Y coordinate of where to position the window. And again, it doesn't return anything, and it tells you that, and gives you an example along with a description of that example. Finally, we have the page for the random function. It tells you how it works, and it gives you a couple examples up here. Pay attention to these notes as well, as they can tell you other things that might be important to know, such as the importance of randomize when you're using random functions. Like window set position, it describes its arguments. And because this function returns something, it tells you the type of thing that it returns. In this case, it returns a real, which means a number. It's returning a number. Again, you can see that it gives an example of the return value up here, and it also gives you an example of how to use the function down here. In summary, functions do something. They can take inputs, and inputs are called arguments, and they may give an output. When we're talking about GameMaker Studio 2 functions, the only way to know what they'll do and whether they take inputs and what type of output they give is to look them up in the manual. And we'll have another tutorial or a couple of tutorials on custom functions or functions that you write, which are called scripts. As always, the links in this slide will be below, along with links to the source code and the slides themselves. And that's it. Thanks for watching.